Welcome back to another Streamline Connector video. This is Sandy speaking, and in this video I'm going to be showing you our latest feature, which is discount codes. We have created a function which allows customers and yourself to create or generate discount codes, and these discount codes can be customizable. As you can see, you have many input variables. I'm going to break it down one by one for you so you can see how to adjust and customize your discount codes. You have a shop ID, which is the same as the one you have been using for our other functions. The discount title, which it is just for reference, so don't fuss too much about it. The discount code, this needs to be unique each time you are generating one, so keep that in mind. It is very important. If you use a discount code which was already generated and it is valid, it will return an error. So in this case, I'm going to show you two different ways to generate discount codes. But yeah, we'll see that in a second. Customer gets, customer selection, and minimum requirements will be objects. So I have prepared a JavaScript step for those variables, which we'll be looking in a second. Then we have starts at and ends at, which will be dates. They do have a specific format. In this case, it is the year, dash the month, dash the day, followed by a T, and the time at which the code will either start or end. In this case, for example, the code starts at the very beginning of the year, and it will last the whole year of 2025. Also remember that it ends with a seed. Then we have the usage limit and applies once per customer, which with these two variables, what you will be adjusting is how many times a specific customer can access the discount. In this case, for example, having the applies once per customer to true and the usage limit to one, we will allow each customer to apply the code just one time. Applies once per customer can be either true or false. Usage limit, it is a number. Then let's have a look at the other variables that we mentioned that were going to be options. As you can see, here we have defined customer gets, customer selection, and minimum requirement. Customer gets indicates, let me trigger the full screen. Customer gets indicates the percentage of the discount code that will apply to the total of the purchase. In this case, it is, for example, 50%. Percentage needs to be a value between 0 and 1. Indicating, for example, if you want to have a discount code of 15%, you write or type in 0.15. Then customer selection indicates to which users the generated code will be available for. In this case, we are offering to all our customers. And then minimum requirement, which is the amount that the user or the customer needs to spend in order to apply the discount code. In this case, for example, we have $100. You can say, for example, 75, and it will work. So, and after each variable is defined, we have to stringify it in order to pass it to the function. So lastly, let's see how the function works. But before that, one last step is this set variable. In this case, I'm using a prompt. It is a basic, very basic one. And here I said, please return a random discount code. And for example, I wrote around 10 to 15 characters can be alphanumeric. So if we hit run, we'll see, for example, it generated a code for us. Let's see the function in action. So it will load the variables first in that JavaScript step. Then it will generate the discount code using AI. It will trigger the function. And in this case, for example, here I've generated in the same discount code, and the error was code must be unique. Please try a different code. So here, for example, the AI generated the same code twice. And let's, the code needs to start with code. For example, let's go again and see what it returns. So for example, here it generated the code, it applied a new a different one. So in this case, the error, we didn't get the error that it wasn't unique. So the other way of using this will be, for example, using an agent step. Here I'm using the default prompt step, the agent prompt, sorry, which is the voice assistant for Acme Solutions. The only thing I've changed here, it is, for example, here for discount codes, I created a few more instructions. In this case, I'm saying discount codes are for 10%, for example. And remember that you will be needing to input variables here in the same way that we did before. As you can see, for example, we have the shop ID. Here, the title will be generated from the conversation in order to be a little bit more custom for the user. And the same with the code. Then customer gets, it is the same variable that I showed you before. Customer selection, minimum requirement. In this case, for example, I set the usage limit to 100 and applies once per customer to true. So let's go ahead and say hit start. It will load the variables again. And for example, let's say I want a discount code. Discount code, please. In this case, for example, I'm going to say that I've submitted a ticket. And they said that I should get a discount code for the inconveniences. And as you can see, the agent step used the function and generated a discount code for me. In this case, it is called support10, and that will be the generated code. So this is just an example on how to use the function. You can have this set of steps, for example, at the end of the support process, I mean when submitting a ticket, after collecting the information of the user and generating the ticket, you can have a discount code generated for them in order to compensate them. Or for example, you could have a discount code generated after using the product recommendations flow, in case the user has, for example, been recommended something they like, you can offer them a discount code in order to encourage them to go with the purchase. So that is all. I hope you like it. Please drop a follow if you enjoyed the video, subscribe to the channel, and let us know in the comments how are you going to be using this new feature.